Thank you. So, welcome to the session after lunch, which is always good. Slower, right? So, we're also not yet asleep, so I'll try to make it entertaining my time as well. First of all, you know, there are a gazillion of sleep working machines because sleep is such a natural design, and so you have them over there, then you don't. So, we have the original interpreter, then there are a couple of good compilers that were never finished. Then there is a good compiler that's called finished with RPM, respect VM, and RPM, and then there's probably VM on Java, and many. They're all running the same thing, just for the scope. And we do have a version that runs on Android, and we have a version that runs on iPhone. Yes, it's based on a design Potato was a sweet VM in Java. Of course, it was a sweet VM in Potato, and what it's done. And I based my design on that machine. In contrast to the original CPM, it does not represent the object as one large chunk of memory. But it maps big objects to extra host objects. So that's a function to do. And that also, crucially, because it's a huge part of the project, lets you use the host garbage collector in combination with my own garbage collector to do garbage collection. That's how it can perform low enough session. So let me talk about that. So we have it running here. So that's the right kernel. It's the best case. We have a mini unit running. It's very small. It's a very old unit, but it works, and you can do things like 20 times benchmarks, and you can see it already takes a couple of seconds, so it's not really fast. But it's faster than the other, so that's it. But let me show you. Okay, there it is. So we're running from less than 1,000 seconds. You're significantly faster on Safari. It's also significantly faster on Internet Explorer. The Chrome right now is a bit behind for this particular workload. So on Safari, I usually get 300,000 seconds. That's about 4. So we've got a really nice compiler based on already. I don't know how the Microsoft guys do it, but they have the source code on it, so it's and select your Chrome rule. So it's working. You can move around, you can type stuff, search for the object. So the nice thing about doing this in JavaScript, and moreover, in lightly term, is that I could develop my tools along with the working machine. So this is a practice to step up the method that I have to do. If you look at my inspector here, where I see the registry fund contest, the VM actually goes into the flag and see that there will be instant variable names. So that's a key one here. So that's working in the department. So there's a computer I just wrote into the idle process. So we see that the main view is that the 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 view is
minus mu on here. And that it's useful for someone implementing a high-level language with JavaScript and another high-level language with JavaScript. It's also just a workaround for these arrays for not having them, so the data we use is the Java root stuff instead loading the course with the object. You can interact in any kind of questions too. And as you show you, it comes for it, but it's really just a kind of code. And then it appends the new object to the old object and gets back to the rest of the system. So that's 3 lines, of course, the interesting stuff happens in these 3 methods. And the mod refer the object to the system. So that's just a start from the use of the special object array and the time. And it goes in there. If it's already marked, then it continues. Otherwise, it looks good. If it is a new object, because it doesn't have to be an object, it remembers that. It marks it, and then it says it's bad, and it refers it to the bad. And so this is discovering all the new methods that we can use. It's not my method. Virtually unlimited memory, yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. I don't have to worry about the extra memory. I just need to be confident. So there's this, in my opinion. Mark reachable objects and remove unmarked objects. It's very simple. The bad thing to use 101 ever implemented link is removing objects. It's simple, it's old, one. I'm just looking at this as the old object and I'm not right. And the next thing is a kind of old object and it would be a lot simpler than this if I didn't touch the edit. So while I'm removing the I don't really need to, but I'm maintaining two object pointers. So to speak, we actually have pointers in the memory, and they are used when you do a snapshot. Maintaining them, and when I remove an object, I adjust all the following objects and the subject of the subject. These groups are not used at runtime. No, they're not used at runtime, but only for saving when you save the image. And I can actually save the image, download it from my browser, and open it. think every other small talk in JavaScript is actually compatible with the fully image-based small talk. I was about to say I've got amended to be one more than two jobs. I don't have to. I could do it as I could do it later just by calculating the size of the dial I'm writing, but now I don't have to do that. And I need a unique ID for object. That's because in JavaScript, just somewhat limited, your dictionary keys are always fixed. You cannot have an object as a dictionary key. You cannot even have an integer as a key. You can, but it gets in a system. I need something that I ever want to use the head for. So I need some kind of ID, and I could just use an allocation number, but because 46 has been so infrequently, I just put it in there. If it ever became a problem, if I were starting problems, it would be very very. I wanted it to be a real CPM. So you cannot only run this old CPMs, but you can actually load more interesting images. Like this year, it's the very latest 4.5 release, the content. It's slower than the mini image, but it also cuts better. And of course, as people work on it, on very fast machines. So you never notice how slow it actually is. If you go back to a slow machine like mine, it really shows how it is. But you can see in the top right corner that it's actually running, there's a little clock going. And I can also open it to you can see the run button shows you the run button shows you how busy it is. Right now it's idle. The highlighted item is wrong. So that's because of my Diplet is still not bug-free. Diplet is very complicated, it's very powerful, but it's a zero mode. So when I perform that VM into the form of 78 VM, it's only one bit better. So much nicer. But it is powerful. And you see this little bubble, this help button, which is actually when we're using the room, also when we need the room for rendering gradients because this is very much in gradients. And we have a seat in the title bar, so there's a subtle gradient up there. And they also are right before I implemented it. Now, the room was done by Andrea Glass. It's a very nice piece of software that's also very big. You have this black support system. But if I had done one to one, it would have been slow. it is a plugin. Plugins are very nice because they present a fixed interface into the concept of virtual. And the interface to the concept is very well defined. So, what my plugin does, I do intend to do a plugin, but it's not using the interface, it's just using the kind of API that I put. So, the small kernels can do gradients, can do busy calls, and so it's branching out to that into a canvas, and then it's reading like the picture is putting them into the form and put them into the screen. Thank you.